Sure. It doesn't look very small compared to this, but that's because this is a 5-inch phone and this is a 4.3-inch phone, so still bigger than the iPhone, which I'll show you in a second. But we want to do a little comparison video and show you what you'd be getting if you picked up a Galaxy S4 Mini versus the full-size Galaxy S4. So let's check it out. Well, first of all, obviously we've got different processors happening in both of these phones. So as opposed to both going with a quad-core processor, the full-size Galaxy S4 has a quad-core 1.9 gigahertz processor, while the Samsung Galaxy S4 Mini only has a 1.7 gigahertz dual core processor. And you can actually see the results of that in the quadrant testing. So here we have 7,161 compared to the Galaxy S4's 12,287. So almost double the quadrant score, which is quite a bit for a device. But then again, quad core, dual core, so about half. But the Galaxy S Mini still runs okay. I would say that in the Samsung apps section, it is a little bit slow in terms of loading compared to, you can see there's a little bit of choppiness there when you're kind of scrolling through things. It's not as smooth as we're used to seeing in the Galaxy S4, the full-sized Galaxy S4. And that's a little bit of a bummer. I think that's something that a lot of people were hoping that maybe we would see a 4.3-inch Samsung Galaxy S4 with the same specs as the full-size Galaxy S4. This wants to update, so I'm going to go ahead and let this update while I tell you guys about the screens, because the screens, to me, are kind of an important thing. So on the Samsung Galaxy S4, you have a full 1080p AMOLED screen. It is gorgeous. It is one of the most beautiful screens out there in terms of smartphones. Unfortunately, Samsung decided not to go even HD with the Galaxy S4 Mini. It's actually got a 960 by 540 resolution, so not even 720, which is unfortunate, all things considered. If you're used to looking at Samsung's beautiful 1080p screen, this can be a little bit disappointing. I'll say that much. It's not quite there. You can see even on our site, the load is a little bit slow in terms of choppiness. You can see, I know that it renders a lot faster on the full-size Galaxy S4. I keep wanting to say the Galaxy S4, but these are both a Galaxy S4 device, so sorry about that. Let's go to Techno Buffalo and see the difference here. Okay, so now we have technobuffalo.com loaded on both devices. Now you can see when we start scrolling, this actually renders a lot quicker. This one, on the other hand, a lot of choppiness. This one definitely kind of takes the cake in terms of speed. But if you wanted to pick up a smaller device, this isn't a bad way to go. I am really disappointed in the screen resolution. That is a bit of a bummer, especially considering Samsung makes such beautiful screens. I mean, just sitting here looking at both devices in hand, you can really see the difference between the 1080p and obviously the 960 by 540 AMOLED. But it still looks sharp enough if you have anybody in your life who is a kind of mid-range phone user and wouldn't notice the difference. They will be perfectly happy with a phone like the S4 Mini. If we wanted to compare it to, say, the iPhone, let's bring an iPhone in and just check out what is going on with the screen size. So you can see here is my iPhone. It's again a little bit smaller still, which is kind of amazing considering this is considered the mini version of the Galaxy S4. iPhone still has a 4-inch screen, but they still look, very similar in terms of colorful app icons, things like that. But generally speaking, the S4 Mini is missing a couple of things compared to the Galaxy S4, the full-sized. Some of the stuff that it's missing is if we go into the camera app, you can see we are actually not going to be able to find the dual camera feature, which is something that a lot of people like on the Galaxy S4. So if we go here, we can see we have our dual feature. Hi guys, I have my pigtails on today. And there's John recording our video, so I'm gonna take his picture. And yeah, so we can do that, but unfortunately, that option is not available on the S4 Mini. So you can see I'm gonna put this down for a second, and you can see we actually don't have that option up here. There are some other options that are not available on the Galaxy S4 Mini. We don't have things like air gestures, air view, smart stay and scroll. There are some features missing, obviously, because of the processing speed needed to use those abilities. So that's an unfortunate loss, but for anybody who doesn't know the difference, or for anybody who is not stepping down from a Galaxy S4 5-inch phone, it's not that big of a deal, I would imagine, because those are features that, while very, very nice, are not necessary to your enjoyment of the phone. But that's pretty much it for today. That's our little mini comparison of the mini. I wanted to do something that wasn't, you know, 10 minutes long and wanted to make sure you guys knew that there were, while some features were missing, there were some things to like about the Galaxy S4 Mini. No word yet on US carriers, no word yet on how much it might be. It wouldn't be a stretch to see this phone come down for less than $99 or even free on subsidy. So very interesting device. The build quality is still that Samsung build quality that some of you know and love and some of you know and hate. So however you feel about that, you will still feel the exact same way with the Galaxy S4 Mini. As always, removable back. You're allowed to swap out your batteries, which I know is a really big deal for some of you Android users out there. This one has a 1900 milliamp battery. That's compared to the Galaxy S4's 2600 milliamp battery. And also it's got a little bit of a camera downgrade in that this is an 8 megapixel shooter, while the full-sized 5-inch Galaxy S4 is rocking a 13 megapixel shooter. So that's it for our little mini comparison of the Galaxy S4 Mini compared to the full-sized Samsung Galaxy S4. See you next video, guys.